Trees grow upwards to outcompete their neighbours. They have trunks and branches so they can go up and reach the light. But there's a group of plants, the climbing plants, that parasitise this process. They parasitise the structure of the trees, so they're called structural parasites. They have roots in the ground, so they don't extract anything else from the plants. Darwin wrote a charming book, The Movements and Habits of Climbing Plants, and he identified five main ways in which plants grow. The first are the twiners, rather like this honeysuckle here, that twines around the plant. Another example would be this bindweed that has twined around this dying elm stem. The second group are the tendril bearers. So tendrils are these fine extensions, modified stems, modified leaves that reach out, twirl round, find something to attach to, wrap round it, and then tighten. So this white bryony here can grow up the outside of this vegetation by means of tendrils attaching to the tree. A similar approach are the leaf climbers, such as this clematis I've taken from the garden. Here, the leaf stems wrap round the vegetation and provide a hold. The fourth approach is adopted by brambles, which, growing through here, there's lots of brambles in the middle of that vegetation there. And these are hook climbers. So they have these rather nasty hooks here. They grow through the vegetation and these just get entangled so that the bramble can keep growing upwards. And then the final group are the root climbers, such as this ivy here. And this climbs by means of adventitious roots, so roots coming from stems that cling onto the tree. They don't extract anything. And then that attachment means that it can then climb up. So if you have twining, if you have plants with tendrils or leaf climbers or hook climbers, they do very well in this sort of thick vegetation. The twining plants can also occur here, but also will wrap around young trees, but they show they're sort of smallish trees, less than 8 centimeters diameter at breast height, usually. So climbing plants are characteristic of new forests, of disturbed habitats, of edge habitats, of habitat fragments. The exception is that the root climbers, so the root climbers just climb up the outside and can do very well in these large trees. And they tend to then prefer, they need light, and so very often they will occupy trees that have been damaged. So this ash has got some ash dieback disease, the canopy's thinner, and it's growing up to take benefit of the extra light. So many people think that it's killing the tree. Well, actually it's just benefiting from a tree that is not very well. These climbers can have considerable ecological consequences. They can suppress growth, particularly lianas, suppress growth, kill some trees, suppress competition, but they have many ecological benefits as well. So that they are a substantial component of biodiversity. In tropical forests, they might be a quarter of the plant species present. They provide habitat complexity and increase the surface area, providing a range of habitats for a diversity of species. They can connect trees together, providing walkways for species to move between trees. They sequester carbon because they're a substantial part of the biomass. they can, some of them, such as these ivy, are a serious source of nectar and berries and contribute greatly to biodiversity. So overall, climbers are a rather neglected group, a fascinating group, but a very important group.